What's up? This is John with Thumper Talk, and today we're talking about something pretty cool. Now, you may have seen it if you've been to any of the pro races, either motocross or off-road series. It's this steering damper by Precision Racing Products. Now, the quick advantages, we'll go into a little bit more detail, but in a nutshell, you can keep your bars stock. It's a small profile, it accounts for thermal expansion, it's a cool gadget. We had to take a look at it, so you know we're gonna take a closer look. Let's get into it. Alright, so there's a couple categories that you want to take a look at when selecting a steering damper, especially when you compare it across the board with what's available. And number one is footprint profile. Number two is overall design. How well does it work? Is it serviceable? Does it leak? How does it connect from the frame to the bars to the unit? And then number three, and almost most importantly for me, at least personally, is can you back it all the way off? So can you take it all the way to zero to where there is no dampening going on? Because when you get into the slow, gnarly stuff, it ends up working against you and you end up wearing yourself out just finding the damper. When you're exhausted or you're racing and you've got that fatigue already kicking in, it can just make it that much worse. All right, so right off the bat, you'll notice that you can leave your bars completely stock. This is a 2018 300 six days, and these are the stock clamps, the stock triples. These are the Phoenix bars, but pretty much the same profile as stock bars. Now it connects via this linkage, so it's not a hoop and pin. It connects via this greased linkage right under here. And then it has this dust boot over it to protect it from the elements. And one of the most important things is its profile. It's short, it's stocky, it's not kind of a pencil sticking up, which can always be dangerous, you know, you just never know. So you want to reduce those factors as much as possible. And so this is a stubby, short profile, which I really liked. It has 20 low speed dampening points on this wheel here that's adjustable easily while you're riding, and then 10 high speed adjustables from underneath that each have an indentation that you can feel as you go. And it's a smooth dampening all the way across the range. It doesn't have the hard stop at 15, 30 or 45 degrees like you can adjust on other brands, but it is just a smooth tapered, and that's really nice for any of you motocross guys that end up in the air, you know, for 100 feet or so. Whenever you move your bars, you don't want the rest of your bike moving with you. And so even with a bar pad, this is easily reached. So the bar pad comes to about here, and we'll show some shots with the bar pad. And that becomes critical because that's where we'll adjust it when we're riding. Now we see all over the forums of people having issues, especially with the earlier models, of other dampers leaking. And that's because they don't account for thermal expansion. Now my unit didn't do it personally, the one that I just took off the bike, but this is specifically designed to account for that factor, and so you won't have that issue. So how does it perform actually on the bike? So riding with this thing at high speed, noticed it was nice and stable. I moved it up to +4 and didn't have any tank slap, no speed wobble. Going into corners, I noticed that I didn't have any chatter. So that was really nice. It felt nice and planted. So probably one of the most noticeable things is in like muddy or slippery conditions, multiple ruts, braking bumps, stuff like that, where it's easy for your rear end to come out of alignment from your front end. It did a great job at keeping them together. So that way you are more stable, you could put the power to the ground and actually be in more control. Now this damper did a great job of keeping the bars stable if you hit something sharp. So a root, a rock sticking up, that obstacle that you didn't see, that thing in the sand, it did a great job at keeping the sharp movements out of it. All right, so this damper from Precision Racing Products, they're an aerospace manufacturing company out of California. Definitely need to be on your short list when you look at dampers. Very impressed with this thing. Just to recap, very small footprint and profile, accounts for thermal expansion, has a bunch of adjustability, and you can back it all the way off to zero. So it's no wonder that the factory boys are running this damper. You should see it more and more. As more guys see it and learn about it, I guarantee you, you'll find it on more. And I was really surprised to see it on professional motocross bikes, because you normally see no sort of damper on those bikes. So really cool to see that. So interesting to see where it goes and who all ends up using it and liking it. But right now we like it. We think you should take a look at it if you're in the market for a damper, but you're gonna want to take what we've talked about, decide if it's right for you and your needs, and go from there to make your decision. We're just trying to help you learn a little bit more about the products to make a better decision, a more informed decision, and we appreciate you tuning in. So we'll catch you guys on the forums. Take care.